And hey, what's up, you guys? Gretel's here. Woo! I love saying that. I don't know why. So, welcome back to my channel, and so nice to see you again. Woo! I'm literally crazy. I don't know what's wrong with me. Can somebody send help? My name is Greta, and if you don't know me already, then I am a yoga teacher by profession. I don't know why I talk like this, but basically, if you have not followed me yet on Instagram already, make sure you do that, because this is the platform where you guys can request me to make any kind of video, send me your DMs, questions, whatever. Let's be friends. Do enjoy, because I do enjoy sharing my experience, and hopefully somehow, in any way, shape, or form, I hope that I... Seriously? In some way, shape, or form, if I can help you in any way by sharing my personal experience, I'm so happy and pleased about that. So again, before we get into video, just wanted to make a little disclaimer. I'm not some kind of enlightened master guru or anything like that. The only things that I talk about in this channel is purely from my own experience and my own opinions. And I don't really like to talk about something which I don't know or have no experience about. The best that I can do is share my opinion and be an open book for you. Okay, so some of you asked me on Instagram, how do I meditate? Okay, so let's talk about meditation. So I made a couple of meditation videos before. If you want to try some guided meditation videos, one will be here, and I guess maybe something will be there or here, I don't know. So I tried many different meditations. I started meditating when I was about 17 years old. I did Vipassana course in silence, 11 days meditation in silence. It's kind of like a Buddhist meditation. And I did it twice in my life. The second time I did it when I was around 21. I did my second silence, 11 days in silence course. Later on, I tried and got into mantra meditation. So currently, I'm much more into bhakti yoga and mantra meditation. That's my current cup of tea, but I still also enjoy mindfulness meditation and things like that. So that's basically my experience with meditation. Nowadays, you hear a lot of people say, oh, I'm practicing this meditation, I'm practicing that meditation. And yeah, for the sake of convenience, it is easier to say I practice meditation, but let's make it clear. Meditation is a state of mind. It's a state of being. It's not something that you can practice, okay? So what we do, we are practicing concentration. So the focus of concentration could be different things, okay? So there's different meditations that are focusing either on the breath or on some kind of mantra, or maybe some sound, or maybe some kind of visual thing, or maybe some movement, or many other different things that I cannot think of at the moment. But there's many different kind of meditation methods that you can like look into and find out, because different people like different kind of meditations. So I don't want to say like you should practice this or you should practice that. You should practice whatever it is that you feel more attracted to and whatever it is that you feel like it works for you. So you need to see intuitively what it is that you need as an individual. But from my personal experience, I found that simple mindfulness meditations really help you to create more space between your thoughts, emotions, and your true self, if that makes any sense. So any mindfulness meditations helps you to kind of detach a little bit from your thought process and your feelings and emotions, instead of identifying with them. Teaches you how to become more like an observer of your life and what is happening in your mind and in your thoughts and emotions. So for me, as somebody who always have been like over emotional and very, very sensitive, that helped me a great deal, because it helped me to find the space between what I was feeling and who I actually was. I realized that I don't have to act and react on my emotions and my thoughts, and I can simply observe them, and that would help me big time. And that in general helped me to really bring much more awareness into my everyday-to-day life. But as well, what I have what have completely changed my life and made me so much happier than I ever was and helped me to experience another level of ecstasy during meditations was definitely mantra meditations. So what I currently practice is the Maha Mantra, the Hare Krishna Mantra. So we, together with other people, we do this singing, dancing kind of meditations. So we play different instruments and we chant, sing this mantra, and you feel really different level of ecstasy, which I have never felt with any other meditation. So that is so far the most, my most favorite meditation. But as well, you can practice this mantra meditation with japa beads. So I'm gonna show you them. So basically I have, this is my bead bag, and basically I have these beads. So these are my beads. So there's 108 beads and one Vishnu bead, which we do not use. So what we do is basically you use your middle finger and your thumb. So basically what we do is we take this bead and we say Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And then you go to another bead and then you say the same thing, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Again, you take another bead and you repeat on like this the whole way down to this bead. And then you do not, oh my god, kind of focus. You do not touch this bead, you just chant on these smaller ones. Once you reach this one, then you turn your beads around and then you start going back. So basically, you can chant like this. So you can say the mantra out loud or you can repeat it in your mind. It's better to say it out loud because hearing is also very important. But you know, if you're doing this like as by walking somewhere outside and you don't feel comfortable and you don't want other people to hear what you are doing, then obviously you can chant quietly in your mind. This is the mantra that I am practicing, but there's some many other mantras. So some people, you know, chant Om Namah Shivaya or Om or Ram or many other different mantras. So I'm not gonna extensively go over in this video. If you want to know more about it, I'm happy to make a part two of this video. So you can drop a comment down below and let me know if that's something you would be interested in. But this is just personally what I practice. But you are welcome to practice anything you want. So that is basically it. So this, what we're doing, it's not really a meditation, okay? Through continuous practice of concentration, when your mind becomes focused enough and still enough to be able to maintain this concentration on one object, then you enter the state of meditation. So the state of meditation, again, in the beginning, it may not be continuous state. You may go into the state and come out of the state. So once you start to practice more regularly, for example, as well, if you're just focusing on very simple like mindfulness or breathing meditations, you will get a lot of thoughts coming into your head in the beginning, and it may be only mainly thoughts, and maybe just for a second you will have the moment of stillness where you be totally absorbed in your breath or the mantra or whatever that is. But for the most part, your mind will not stop going. And that doesn't mean that you cannot meditate or that you fail or you suck at meditation, because a lot of people give up because they think that they cannot meditate. And from my own experience, when I first started meditating, it was, my mind was just going like crazy. But the more I practiced, the moments of this peacefulness and quietness and calmness started to extend. But as I said, do not expect that this will happen from the first time that you sit down for your meditation, okay? Meditation takes time and it's a lifelong process. So through continuous practice of concentration, you can enter into the state of meditation. So once you really become absorbed in the state of meditation, anything can become your meditation. So it's not that you just sit down and sit for 20 minutes or 1 hour and half an hour a day or even 5 minutes a day and that is your meditation. No, the moment you come out of your meditation, you should still be able to maintain the state of meditation. So as I said, anything can be your meditation. So even walking down the street can be a meditation, cooking a meal can be a meditation, painting can be a meditation, editing a video can be a meditation, talking to your friend can be a meditation. Anything you do can be a meditation as long as your mind is in a state of meditation, as long as your mind is meditative, peaceful, and calm. So once this state of meditation becomes pervading throughout your life, you can enter the state of enlightenment, which is called samadhi. So this subject I don't know much about because I'm not there yet, but you can get glimpses into what it is like to experience that through the practice of concentration, or what other people say, meditation. So that is my answer and my take on how to meditate. So I hope this guys help you in any way, shape, or form, and I hope this brings a little bit more clarity on what it is that people are keep on rambling about nowadays. Meditation. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and please, if you want me to make a part two of this video and talk more about different types of meditation, or maybe expand more on the meditation one, maybe you want to hear more about this Maha Mantra meditation that I'm currently practicing, please let me know, leave a comment down below, and I will be happy to make it. Other than that, I'm really happy and pleased that you stayed until the end of the video, and if you're still here, I hope you're enjoying my videos. So if you are enjoying my videos, make sure to hit that subscribe button and put the bell on so you get notified every time I post a new video. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, give it a like, because that helps a lot to support my channel. And I'm very thankful with you guys. If you'd like to share this video with anyone who you think this may help, please, you're very welcome to do that. And other than that, I guys will see you in the next video. Mwah!